Hey y'all, this is D coming at you with D's Attic Talk. Today I'm going to do a little walkthrough slash review slash comment on a game that I'm very, very fond of, and that's the Tomb Raider series. Now, they've had a lot of games over the years, and from the very first game, I was hooked, and I never looked back. But I would definitely have to say, so far, out of all of them in the series, Tomb Raider Legends is the one that I like the most. So we are playing on the PlayStation 3. We're playing the trilogy, which has Legends, Anniversary, and Underworld. And they're all good games. I mean, not too many Tomb Raider games were bad off. Most of them were pretty good. But the last couple that came through the trilogy, like the rebirth and the rebranding and everything else, because Crystal Dynamics doesn't work on it anymore. Eidos doesn't work on it anymore. Like, they steered away from the original concept that all these companies were doing with it. And now they're going into a different direction. That's cool. I'm hoping that it'll come back, because now, as of 2022, they are going to be creating another Tomb Raider game, and I'm just really hoping it brings back to the adventure of Lara Croft that we know. Experience, wealthy, agile, attitude, adventurous, boom. I mean, these are just some of the still shots of the game loads of the trilogy. So like I said, the Legends is one of my favorite ones. And one of the things I like best about the Legend one is Croft Manor. Now, I definitely have some plans, some thoughts. I've been thinking about the next Tomb Raider game since this ever came out. I mean, obviously, they did various games after that. And some games took to the concepts of what I was thinking. But what I want to do, and just share my thoughts and ideas so that someone will hear me, bring back the Lara Croft that we're fond of. Yeah, she can have people that'll help her out, but she's adventurous, she's skillful, she's, you know, doesn't fear of any type of, she can take on any type of situation. She is a Tomb Raider. So, let's get into this. We're going to do just, this video is just going to focus on the mansion. Now, in my concept, her mansion is very big, very well established, very intricate, where every single thing has an option, a movement, a purpose. You can move something 2, 3, 4 different times, and it'll give you 4 or 5 different results. You know, different types of chandelier hanging, like anything that you can think of in Croft Manor, this is where we're at. So when you start off in Legends, you start off, it's just little Lara. She doesn't have anything. So you have to come in here to your tech room, visit Zip. You gotta go into the safe over here, which then gives you your grappling hook. And once you get the grappling hook, you can do different things that are inside your mansion. And then you go, might as well go upstairs and get our guns. There's something that's going to be moved here and activate that. But in the game that I'm thinking about, yes, it's going to have all these different doors, all the nice detail, but everything's going to be interactive. If I want to pull these shades closed, I can pull each and every one of these shades closed. You know, different things might be clues, like that shield might have a clue behind something. This is the library. This is definitely a place where I'm going to have to come back after I get my guns. I'll pick up the light source here real quick. It's not letting me. Alright, there we go. So
you're
now...
You're not going outside, are you?
Not when there are still so many interesting dark places inside.
Yes. Like, this is what brought me back, and it's like being able to walk around in the halls. Now, in my game, you're going to start off in Croft Manor, and Lara's going to be able to check emails, letters, packages, all different types of things that will either lead to missions, DLC, purchase items, just anything. Options are endless. But when you start off, you can either go right to the mission, or you can do various things inside the mansion to gain XP. Now, this is like a big foyer room. Here's a outfit room, and this is good, but my outfit room is going to actually have all the outfits open so you can see them. So every single outfit that Lara has ever played with, if you unlock it, earn it, whatever, by playing the game different times or doing different things, you'll unlock the various outfits. Scuba outfit, formal wear. I mean, let's see what they have as options here. You know, I have to unlock some, but right now we only have Legend, Legend Blue, Biker, and Evening. Winter, and Winter with no coat. But there's a lot of different options that I can select or earn. Same premise for my game. Different outfits will give you different storage. If she's wearing cargo pants, you know, she can hold a couple of extra items. Different size backpacks. Now, she can have these guns here in like a little secret safe wall, but she is going to have a main arsenal where her firing range is and her running gun course is going to be. And that's where, you know, players can build the gun shooting skills of Lara with the dual cannons, one, machine guns, whatever, you know, piece of equipment that's in her arsenal. Players will be able to buy guns, customize guns. One of the things that I want to say, the reason why Lara has these guns up in the safe by her bedroom, and these can be engraved with mom and dad on each of them, so she always has her parents by her side whenever she goes on any adventure. But now that we got my guns, now that we got the grappling hook, let's go into the library. And this is what I like, you're doing different things, grabbing different items. You know, I want to be able to load up Lara the way I need to. Have her head calm so she can talk to people. Go upstairs. See all these books? Now, in my theory, in my game, this room right here in the library would be like the media room. And players can earn every single game and play it. Or, if they've played it and completed it, they can watch the cinematic version of that game. So they can pick whichever one on the library, come over to a recliner somewhere, chill here. Instead of all these blinds, where like a big blind comes down where it's like a projection screen to make it black in there, and then players will be able to watch or play the game that they've picked or that they've earned. Have all these little secret passageways. Now, I did find this kind of dumb. I don't know if I ever figured it out or if there was something else to it, but why would you just have something open to nothing? I can't even hide in there. I can't even close myself. You got books that clearly stand out, but I can't do anything with. Maybe I gotta unlock something. I don't know. There's a book there that stands out. But I know one thing that stands out, and that's this bookshelf.
I suppose there's no point in my offering to help you get what you need in a less calamitous manner.
I didn't hear you offering any manner at all, much less a calamitous one. But thanks, old sir.
Only as it needs to.
See, this is what I miss about Lara. You had to figure out puzzles in order to open up other areas.
Your enthusiasm truly inspires me, Lara.
Don't be sarcastic, Alistair. It's dishonest.
I asked Winston to install a handle for you, but he didn't even offer the courtesy of a reply.
He probably thought it was a rhetorical question. I would have. Above the waters, twin sisters turn their backs, one upon the other, to leave their umbrages unguarded. Lovely.
On the new game, so she definitely has more skills. There's like a relic or something around here.